Finance leaders from the Group of Seven Nations pledge cooperation on Iran sanctions. The G7 finance ministers and central bank governors met on the sidelines of the International Monetary Fund and World Bank spring meetings in Washington. The officials said they would ensure close coordination to diminish Iran's ability to acquire, produce, or transfer weapons. That's as they admit significant geopolitical risks affect global growth outlook. But they asserted central banks remain strongly committed to achieving price stability and ensure the continued resilience of the global economy to multiple shocks. The U.S. set to reimpose sanctions on Venezuela's oil and gas sector. This is in response to President Nicolas Maduro's failure to allow an inclusive and competitive election to take place. Opposition leader Maria Corina Machado, who has been barred from running in the polls, said Maduro's government had failed to honor that commitment. The U.S. Treasury Department on Wednesday gave companies 45 days to wind down their operations and transactions in Venezuela's oil and gas sector. But the head of Venezuela's pro-government legislature insists they had fulfilled the terms of last year's deal and that the reinstatement of the sanctions shows Washington is again free or against free elections in the country. An ambitious effort aiming to provide electricity to 300 million people in Africa in the next 6 years now underway. Leading the charge, the World Bank and African Development Bank Group. The World Bank will work to connect 250 million electricity through distributed renewable energy systems or the distribution grid, while the African Development Bank will look to provide energy to the other 50 million. The World Bank estimates $30 billion of public sector investment will be needed for the project. Currently, some 600 million Africans lack access to electricity. State Weather Bureau PAGASA warns temperatures, especially in Luzon, will likely continue rising, especially during the month of May. According to PAGASA's Climate Monitoring and Prediction Section Chief Ana Solis, there's a possibility that parts of the Philippines will experience a heat index of 52 degrees Celsius and above in the coming weeks. She urges caution as these dangerous conditions put the public at risk of heat strokes.
Historically kasi, medyo ang matataas nating temperatura na itala during the months of April as well as during the months of May. Kaya dito nakikita natin na possible pa rin na patuloy na iinit at tataas ang ating temperatura. Pagdating ng Mayo, asahan po natin lalo na dyan sa may parte ng Cagayan Valley area, dyan po sa may parte ng Isabela, ng Cagayan, pati na po dyan sa may Ilocos region, medyo may init din po. Kasama na po dyan yung sa Central Luzon area and also itong mga karating na mga probinsya ng Metro Manila, dyan po sa Batangas, Cavite, na medyo coastal areas.
Corporate stories this Thursday. Manila Water is taking a majority stake, in fact, in the firm which manages Laguna's water district. Its unit is buying 70% of shares in Equi Pacific Holdco, Incorporated, for 1.15 billion pesos. EHI has a 90% stake in the joint venture, which operates and maintains the water supply in 5 towns in Laguna. The acquisition will allow Manila Water to strategically grow operations in the province. Next, Balaini Frutas, further diversifying its product offerings. Lesser use firm signed a deal today to acquire the 40-year-old Sugar House Bake Shop for a still undisclosed amount. Balai is also taking over the catering business of Sugar House, with the acquisition set to be completed by May. In other company news, Basic Energy and Japan's Renova teaming up for a wind project in Batangas. The two firms entered into a joint development and shareholders agreement to develop the 50-megawatt wind power facility in Mabini Town. The wind project begins operations by 2027 with an estimated cost of 4.5 billion pesos. Finally, in earnings, Rockwell Land surpasses its pre-pandemic profit. Its net income after tax was at 3.4 billion pesos last year, higher by 31% year on year. The Lopez family's property developer also posted higher revenues of 18.5 billion pesos from its residential and commercial businesses. It notes, retail revenues were up 27% on improved occupancy and rental rates on top of new retail store openings.